Sup guys, welcome back to another UHJ. So I've noticed that whenever I do commentaries about the game or some shit, I never do too well in the game. I don't know why, it just happens to be a thing. So what I was thinking is maybe I'll do like a little story time before PvP. The moment I get into PvP, I'm gonna shut the fuck up and play my game. Alright, so when I was like really young, I want to say I was in grade 1 or possibly 2, I think maybe grade 1. At my old like elementary, primary, whatever kind of school, there was this, it wasn't really safe back then when I was younger. I mean, I checked the old school now and it's very like safe, but basically whenever there was recess or like lunch or something, outside of the school there's like a fat fucking hill, bro, like this fat hill where you have to go run down, where you play your tag or your, and basically on this hill kids would have to, like, including me, we'd all like run on this hill. Fuck this skeleton. And typically running down this hill, looking back, probably wasn't the safest thing, but every kid, there was about like 400 kids, I'm not even kidding, who would run down that thing at lunch. Probably more, maybe 500. It was a pretty big school, to be honest. Point is, there was this lunch caretaker, whatever they're called, who like supervises. Her name was Mary. She was like old, sweet as hell. See, the thing was, as a kid, I was never the type, I was very like, very shy, very not into me, a little bit of a goofball, right? And so this is one of the only lunches where me and my friends, we were like, oh, let's go play cops and robbers or some shit. And what you don't understand is when I mean 500 kids run down at lunch, I mean it's like a fucking herd of animals running down to just go play some tag or whatever the fuck you do. Now I want you to imagine this, where the first time I ever run as a kid, like down these things, and with this whole herd about like 300, 400 people running down this one big hill, it's like, bro, it's like amazing what Mary did that day, okay? Imagine you're a fucking bison, okay? You're a fucking bison, okay? And your whole herd, you're just in the middle. You're in the middle. You feel safe, okay? You feel so safe. You're just in a pack, you know? All these big bison are around you, right? Or pretend you're in the fucking Spartan army, okay? And you have the shield wall and the Persians are shooting down at you, right? You're like, okay, there's no way anything could happen to me, right? What fucking happened to me is imagine one big fucking Quetzalcoatlus just comes down and swoops me out of my bison herd. Or for example, in the whole Spartan wall, one big fucking arrow come and lands right in my fucking eye. And if you don't get the reference is as I went down, Mary fucking comes down, chases me like I'm a fucking animal, and just takes away any of my human rights, say, putting me in detention for running down the hill. But no, there was about 300 other people going down that hill, so why me? And, you know, I'm like, I'm Middle Eastern, not really Middle Eastern, I'm like from Afghanistan, so no, I'm not Middle Eastern, but the point is here is like, I was thinking maybe I should call the race card, right? I mean, back then I didn't know that, but dude, everyone at that school was like, not white. I mean, there's probably like one white guy at that school, because I grew up in like a pretty, well, not really white people area. Basically what she did is she put me on the wall of the whole school, like the school wall, and then I was in detention the whole lunch. And I never understood why it mattered, or why if she was gonna get one person, why didn't she get like 50 other people? But it's okay, because I mean, she let me out 3 minutes before recess ended, so